Hey YouTube, Koppersan here. Did you ever hear the tragedy of the White Mage the Wise? No, I thought not. It's not a story the job instructors would tell you. It's a dark legend, really. After studying the dark side, the White Mage became so powerful, he couldn't even die. Unfortunately for him, when he was still the White Mage, he taught his apprentice everything he knew. Then his apprentice, together with a bunch of MapleStory heroes, sealed him away. In the final battle, the student had to drain some of the dark powers from his former master to weaken him, corrupting himself before being cursed as well by his former master. He wakes up hundreds of years later, weak and low level, but ready to pick up where he left off against his former master. Ladies and gentlemen, today we're getting Illuminated as we're training a Luminous to level 200 in E-Reboot. Luminous is not a class for the indecisive. Right during the tutorial, you gotta pick the light side or dark side. And you might think that joining the light side is a superior tactic, but joining the dark side is great as well.
Do it.
Light is great for grinding, since your 4-drop light mobbing skill is amazing, but the dark skills are great against bosses, so if you're looking more towards the endgame, then dark might be a better choice. But honestly, in the end, it doesn't really matter that much. Until level 30, we're stuck with the Luminous questline, so let's go over our skills instead. In your beginner job, you'll get a special blink skill that will allow you to teleport to a random location on the map, just like all those hackers. Your inner light skill increases your willpower, insight and int, and increases your MP when leveling up as well. And since you are Luminous, the beacon of light, you're also immune to the darkness status effect as well. Wow. Crazy. Luminous's link skill can go up to level 3 and it gives you 20% ignore enemy defense at that point. His legion gives flat int. If you are bossing on a different character and you're missing some ignore enemy defense, then getting a Luminous link skill might be useful. Anyway, first job skills. In first job, you'll get an actual teleport skill called Light Speed. What makes this teleport awesome is that you're invulnerable to physical attacks for a short while after you teleport. You sort of like gain dark sight. And what's even more awesome is that this skill increases your movement speed and gives you plus PSD jump jump. I mean, you gotta have that sick PSD jump jump. Luminous also has a passive magic guard. Nexon, please, just do this for every mage class. Just so you never need to cast it. Honestly, I've died so many times on my previous mage classes because I keep forgetting that magic guard gets cancelled when you die or just when you log in and you can't find the button quick enough and you're dead. And your first attacking skill is Flash Shower, which isn't too great, but let's be honest, there aren't that many amazing first job skills. I mean, we can't all be Pathfinders. After finishing the questline, we reach level 30 and we're ready for our Luminous mechanics to take shape. Luminous is a changed man since he was first released all the way back in 2012. He has a light and dark side gauge that has to be managed by either spamming the corresponding light or dark attack, depending on the mode that you're in. And once you fill up that gauge, you'll reach equilibrium mode, granting him even more buffs. If you are in light mode, your light attack lines are doubled, and the additional lines deal 50% damage. And attacks will heal for 1% of your base HP, so infinite healing as long as you keep attacking. In dark mode, your lines are doubled as well, and you deal 50% of the final damage, same stuff. And your dark skills won't cost any MP when used. And when you fill up that gauge and you reach equilibrium mode, in this mode you'll get 100% stance, and your attack deal double the lines at 100% damage, so yay more damage. And after 4 drop, your teleport turns into the Battle Mage teleport, meaning you can jump and teleport around, which is super awesome. Oh, and all the damage that you take during this time as well is reduced to 1. So not only is he fast, he's strong, he's tanky as well. And by the way, if you are enjoying the video so far, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more MapleStory content. Make sure to hit the bell notification as well so you never miss a video. Your light attacking skill in second job, a Sylvan Lance, is pretty awesome. Your dark attacking skill is kinda lame though. You have to steer it around, which isn't too great. Your dark blessing skill creates orbs every couple of seconds when you haven't been attacked. 3 orbs can be created in total, and your magic attack increases with the more orbs that you have. Once you take a hit, one orb disappears and you only take 30% damage from that hit, so yes, even more tankiness. Nice. I again completed the Elinel Fairy Academy and Rihanna Stray Team Dungeon. Only 4 characters left to train to level 200 for this series, and I seriously hope I'll never have to visit this area again. At level 56, I went to the Boar's Empyrean at the top left of the map, and we hit level 60 at the normal excavation site in Pyrion. In third job, your light and dark skills work the other way around. Your light attacking skill Spectral Light is a skill that can only be used when standing still, and you gotta turn around and steer that beam up and down. It is strong, but you are very immobile as you literally can't move. The dark attack skill Moonlight Sphere is pretty dope though. It has plenty of range and damage. Luminous is a very tanky boy. After getting reduced damage from his previous job skills, in his third job, the buff skill Dusk Guard makes you ignore damage 20% of the time. imagine the most powerful monster attacking Luminous, and he's like, yeah, I'm just gonna ignore that. Pretty broken. His Lunar Tide skill is also interesting. If you have more MP than HP, your damage is increased by 20%, and if your MP is lower than your HP, your critical rage is increased. But usually as a mage, you don't want to have your MP lower than your HP, so I guess that really doesn't happen that much. Your Shadow Shell skill allows you to ignore status conditions as well, because Luminous just ignores everything. And your Ray of Redemption attack that has a 5-second cooldown will heal you as well. So we got heals, take reduced damage, and sometimes straight up ignore damage. This mage can take a beating, man. Luminous also gets one of the, in my opinion, most awesome looking skills in the game, Death Sight. This attack can be used every 24 seconds, but when you are in Equilibrium mode, it can be spammed to your heart's content. Man, when you are in Equilibrium mode, you do so many lines of damage, it's so good. It's so satisfying to look at. And in maps like Sandcastle Playground, this skill works really well with all these map teleporters just sitting around. After gaining a couple more levels, I felt a bit ballsy. Sometimes you gotta test your limits a little bit, you know? So I went to Zakum at level 94, which was a bad idea. But at least now he'll underestimate us when we come back later, right? It's better to go to normal Zakum at level 100 to reboot. Leafra is a great place to train after you reach the Forge Job, and instead of going to the map we always go to, that's Sky Nest 2 or whatever, this time I went to Valley of the Antelope to destroy some very evil looking sheep. And those evil Black Antares needed to be stopped as well, so I trained there for a couple of levels. I know that in any reboot, most maps can be pretty full at times, so today I'm going to some different training spots just to show you that you can train anywhere. Any map's a training map if you're brave enough, you know? But anyway, we reached Forgeop. Finally, we reached a whole new level of standing still and defeating monsters. The previous class that we trained to level 200 was Evan, which, to be honest, sometimes felt like I was playing Friday Night Funkin'. But Luminous is the exact opposite of Evan in that sense. We stand still, we use reflection, and sometimes we turn around and then use reflection again. And that are the high level mechanics of training with the Luminous. As you might already know, we stream every class that we train to level 200 on Twitch, and there was a debate going on in the chat if putting reflection on a macro makes it cast a bit faster when turning. And of course, I have blind faith in chat, so I put reflection on the macro as well, but if there are any Lumi mains in the chat, let me know if this is actually true or if it was patched already. Reflection is such an amazing grinding skill, honestly. I put all my hyper skill passes on this skill just to make it even better. You can increase your range, you can reduce the splash damage reduction to none and deal more damage as well, it's beautiful. Your dark attacking skill in Forgeop is Apocalypse, which isn't too bad either, but it isn't reflection, so it's less good to train with by default. I did put a point in my passive hyper skill for Apocalypse, just so my gauge will fill quicker if I use the skill, just so I could spam reflection more often. Luminous only gets 10 skills in his Forgeop, and most of them go to level 30. His other new attack is called Morning Star, which, while cool looking, I rarely use. It summons a meteor that pushes back monsters and deals damage. And then there is Ender. This attack has a cooldown, but can be spammed during Equilibrium. And bloody hell, what are those lines? What is this damage? There also are passive hyper skill boosts for Ender, but I assume you only want to take those when you go bossing. And his Darkness Mastery skill boosts the duration of Equilibrium by 7 more seconds. Now we can stay in that mode for 17 seconds. Spamming Ender and Deathsight for 17 seconds? Hell yeah. His other Forgeop skills are mainly buffs, increasing his damage, final damage, and ignore enemy defense even more. Thanks to the Morningstar passive and Arcane Pitch skills, Luminous gets a whooping 70% final damage increase. Luminous hits and feels and moves like a truck. His active hyper skill makes everything perfectly balanced. It's called Equalize. It puts him in his equilibrium state right away, so you can keep spamming Deathsight and Ender when needed. Or if you just want to be longer in light mode, you can just skip the dark side skills and just go straight over to light mode again. His other active hyper skill is Armageddon, which is an iframe, stuns monsters, and blows up everything on the screen. Still, not as good as reflection, but this one comes pretty close. It's a great skill to use when bossing, but the 2-minute cooldown is lengthy. We swam our way to level 200 and reach 5th job. For exchange of an arm and a leg, we open our gate and can now perform the skill Gate of Light in 5th job. Gate of Light can only be activated during Equilibrium mode, but it has no cooldown, so if you use Equalize right after you run out of Equilibrium time, you can just use it again right away. This skill is a massive summon that fires off rays of light and dark every now and then for even more destruction. And according to the very well translated skill description, you can attack people with this, so have fun PvPing, I guess. But you know, it feels like Luminous only gets mobbing attacks. So to balance that out, Nexon added another mobbing attack to his 5th job skill called Aether Conduit. Depending on if you are in light, dark or equilibrium mode, the shape of this attack changes. Luminous places down a conduit that fires beams of light or darkness or both, dealing a ton of damage, and it has some decent range as well. The 30-second cooldown is not too bad either. Now after you advance to your 5th job, when you use Ender, you build up stacks of Baptism of Light and Darkness. 12 stacks is the max, and once you hit that, the cooldown of this skill will be reset. Use the skill to make swords fly out, dealing damage to nearby enemies. This skill always crits and ignores 100% of the enemy defense. Wow, look at that, an actual nice bossing skill. And your final 5th job skill is Liberation Orb. Passively, your light and dark attacks get special effects. Light attacks create zones to deal damage, and dark attacks create a magical bullet that bounces back and forth between enemies. When activated, your attacks will create orbs that attack enemies, and this effect can trigger up to 20 times. Luminous will accumulate stacks when attacking with light or dark skills. And the more stacks you have before activating the skill, the more the damage of those orbs get boosted. Light and dark stacks can both go up to 4, so 8 in total, 4 of each. And that's Luminous, a monster when it comes to grinding, and while his bossing isn't top tier, his 5th job skills do help him take down the big baddies a bit faster. He is tanky, deals a lot of lines of damage, but his attacks aren't that fast, and high level, highly skilled reflection grinding usually means getting the high ground in a map somewhere and just spamming reflection left and right, which might not be the playstyle for everyone. What do you think about Luminous? Let me know in the comments. And that was all for today. As always, many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Niels de Konnik, Rama Waar, Sebastian Hanoi, FLX, Jeff Wong, Pinky Traveler, Terry Kim, Jiju, Galaxy Art, Gesus Rodriguez, Varese, Ryser Ryu, Dries Sumker, Plux, Zenny, Wiley, Francisco Sousa, History Cannon, Backspace, OTI, CMAX, Safronix, Lonzo, BG Extremes, Harry Gartner, Ido Heimann, Anwar NHI, Brandon, Frank Bouguet, Ziggy Deer, Fine Asian Guy, Mr. Potemkin, Flidiot, Beamer WT, Lars Schmidt, Edgar, Knifesu, and Chain125. If you would like to be mentioned here as well, support the channel and get access to early videos, make sure to check out the join button below this video. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Stay safe and happy mapling!